Okay, so what a hamburger navigation is, it is one of those buttons that you see usually on mobile or when you zoom in really close on a website, that when you click on them, they reveal a menu. And then when you click again, they close the menu. Hamburger menu is difficult to find because, as it is well known, business owners don't really care about disabled people if their website isn't accessible, but that's another rant of mine that I like making. It is called a hamburger menu because it looks kind of like a hamburger. You have the top bun, the burger itself, I guess that's what it's called, and the patty, and the bottom bun. My husband is really into making hamburgers. He buys hamburger stuff every month. We have a flat top, a smash burger, instruments. We have a mandolin for Frida burgers. Those are cumin burgers. Anyways, I'm enjoying it because I get to eat very tasty burgers. Anyways, this hamburger menu is accessible because when I press enter, it closes and opens, and when I press the space bar, it closes and opens as well. However, most hamburger menus are inaccessible. Let me show you. This is what usually a hamburger menu looks like. It is very bad because it uses the A element for the button itself, which is really bad. It usually has an href and a pound key so that the element is still selectable via the keyboard. The href is used in good, bad hamburger menus, if you get what I mean, because usually sometimes people, they just remove it, and this makes the button itself not being able to be focusable with the keyboard. So that's what it is. It's just a link that is made to look like a button and it's clickable. And when you click on it, you know, it opens and closes the menu. So you might be thinking, well, Stefany, this looks like perfectly normal to me. The only thing that needs to be changed is from the anchor link to the button, right? Well, not exactly, because when a screen reader lands on this bad markup, it's not going to announce the stuff you wanted to announce. Let me show you a really bad hamburger in action. So this is a website that its hamburger menu is so bad, it's not allowing me to navigate to it using the tab key, so I have to use the arrow keys, which is bad. But I'm going to show you how bad it is and how bad screen readers announce badly written hamburger menus. So I'm going to be using NVDA, which I know is a desktop screen reader, but it's going to say almost the same things as VoiceOver or TalkBack will say on Android and iOS. So I'm going to fire up my screen reader now. Okay, right now we have selected the hamburger menu and the screen reader just says clickable. Now notice carefully.
Link graphic lock online bill pay, clickable.
Now I'm going to expand the hamburger using the enter key. Notice how the hamburger expands, but the screen reader doesn't say that it's expanded. I'm going to collapse it now. No feedback from the screen reader. Not only that this hamburger doesn't have a name, it just says clickable, but the screen reader isn't announcing when the hamburger is being expanded or collapsed. Now we're going to test the good hamburger on the Wise website.
Menu button collapse sub menu.
Notice how it says menu button and it says that it's collapsed. Now I'm going to expand it using the enter key.
Expanded.
Awesome. Now I'm going to collapse it with the enter key.
Collapsed.
I'm going to do the same thing with the space bar.
Expanded. Collapsed.
Excellent. That's how a hamburger menu should behave, and that's what makes it accessible. Okay, now that we figure out what makes a bad hamburger bad, let's code a good one. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go where our markup is, and we're going to go to our navigation. So let's look how this looks right now at the front end. So I'm going to do this and I'm going to find the page. Okay. So this is our page right now, and it doesn't show because we don't have a hamburger yet. So imagine that over here is the navigation. Now let's start coding. So you want your hamburger to be inside the nav tag. So when users navigate it with the screen reader, the screen is going to say navigation menu. So let's do that. And what I'm going to do is we're going to use the button element. No button. And I'm going to give it an ID of hamburger. Okay, and we're going to give it an area expanded. Remember, area expanded is important because we want our screen reader to announce when the hamburger is expanded or collapsed. Expanded, and I'm going to give it an initial value of false. You know, because when you open up a website on your phone, 90% of the time the menu is collapsed. So we want this menu to be collapsed. Okay, and now we want to add an icon, which is the pad, and that's usually an SVG icon. I usually get them from material icons, so I'm gonna paste it right now. Okay, so this is our icon, and it looks pretty cool, I think so, if I say so myself. Now the next thing we wanna do is, you can leave that as it is. So if you don't want to have a visible label on your hamburger, you can leave it as it is, and then you have to add an area label. So when a screen lands to the menu, it's going to say menu. Right now, it doesn't have an area label or a visible text, so when the screen lands on it, it's just going to say button, or it's going to say clickable. And this is very, very, very something we don't want to do. So if you were coding just a hamburger without visible text, I have to add area, and then I usually say menu, okay? And as you see, the area label is invisible. It's only for assistive technologies like screen readers or Braille refresher displays. But when it comes to icons, I think the most accessible you can make them is to always add text next to the icon. So I'm going to add a text next to my burger menu. Okay, our burger menu has text. Now, what I don't like about this text is that it is in all caps. When you write text in all caps or even in small caps like it is right now, it looks kind of the same. All letters look the same. It's all like a rectangle. So people with dyslexia or with learning disabilities are going to have trouble reading it. So what I usually do is I disable that. So let's find where this is, it where the CSS rule for the font variant is. I don't remember if it was, yeah, I think it was font variant, font size. Okay, form variant small cap. So I'm going to remove that because we want to make it more accessible. Okay, see, it's much easier to read now because you can actually see the difference between all the letters. It's difficult to explain, but just trust me on that. Always use title case or sentence case. You can use all uppercase if it's like an error or something that really requires the user's attention. But 99% of the time, title case or sentence case is nice. Okay, so the next thing we want to do is, since we have a visible label, we can remove this area label. Why? If you have a visible label and an area label, screen readers are mostly going to ignore this visible label, or they're going to announce menu twice. So they're going to read the label once, and they're going to read the visible label another time. And that's not what we want, because that's going to be bad user experience. But 99% of the time, when you have an area label, all the text as a child of the button or link, it's going to get ignored by screen readers. So I'm going to remove this area label, and okay, I'm going to save it. Okay, so that's like the basics of an accessible hamburger. You have the area expanded false or true, you have the icon, and then you have the label, which is going to be menu span, which is going to be a span, and then it's going to be a menu. I've also added area hidden true so that screen readers are not going to read all of that text. You know, we don't want that to happen. So the next thing we want to do is, let me see. So this is the JavaScript I have written for this menu. It's not the best JavaScript, but it works, and I was trying to make it intentionally simple, so you know, it's easier to understand. It's pretty straightforward. Okay, so our hamburger is looking pretty good right now. I'm going to check if it has an outline. Yes, it has an outline. I usually try to make them 44 by 44 pixels, which is a WCAG AAA success criterion. So, you know, also it's easier for people who have cerebral palsy or Parkinson's disease to select it, because they tend to have hand tremors. And, you know, or have you ever tried to select a very tiny button on a phone? It's not a pleasant experience, that's for sure. So that's why I have it big, good contrast, outline on select and on focus. Now let us try to see if it works on with a keyboard. So I'm going to turn on my keyboard, on screen keyboard. Okay, pressing tab once, pressing tab again, enter, it expands, awesome. Now I'm going to try spacebar, it expands. Great, works as expected. Okay, so now I have turned on my screen reader. We're going to test our hamburger menu. I'm going to select
menu button collapsed.
So it says, okay, good. I'm going to expand with enter key.
Expanded, collapsed.
Spacebar.
Expanded, collapsed. Homepage graphic visited link. Menu button collapsed.
It announces menu button collapsed. Excellent. I'm going to turn off my screen reader using insert plus Q. So one other thing I want to show you, that it is important when you have a menu button like this, a hamburger menu button, when you click it, the focus must remain on the button. And then whenever a tab is pressed, the tab key, the first element of the navigation or the first element of the expanded content must be selected. So if you have, for example, if we have the menu right here on the left of the logo, it would have been wrong because you need, when you press tab, the first item to be the newly expanded content. That's it. It's pretty simple. I'm going to link this code, all of this code, so you can check it out later, but that's pretty much it, how you create an accessible burger. And it's very important that you tweak the area expanded with JavaScript, because just adding area expanded, it's not going to make a change on click. You have to do that via JavaScript. And that's it, that's how you create an accessible navigation with a hamburger. If you want to make the hamburger menu even better, make it progressively enhanced, which means if the user has JavaScript off, the menu should be expanded on page load, and if they have JavaScript on, it should be collapsed.